Hi, Meera. Welcome to our show.
Wonderful to be here.
Yeah, it's first time you're on my show, so thank you very much for coming here.
Great pleasure. Great pleasure.
Okay, you know, you adapted novels in the past too, right? So what made you adapt this one into a film?
Well, the first bolt of inspiration to make The Reluctant Fundamentalist was not the novel, actually. It was my first invitation to Lahore.
Wow.
And my father had grown up in Lahore before the partition. Mm-hmm. And he raised us in India, you know, knowing the poems of Faiz Ahmed Faiz, knowing the music of Iqbal Bano and Noor Jahan. And we speak essentially Urdu Hindustani.
Right.
And so when I first went to Lahore, just a few years ago, it was quite a moving experience, that the sort of warmth and hospitality and this culture that was familiar and yet I had never been there.
Mm-hmm.
And so I wanted to make a modern tale about Pakistan because it's not what you read about in the newspapers.
Absolutely, yeah.
Then I came across Mohsin Ahmed's wonderful novel about a year and a half later.
So you seem to be quite inspired by Lahore, but why didn't you shoot the film there?
Well, actually, we wanted to shoot the film there, but this is a very big star cast, you know, from Hollywood, from Kate Hudson to Liev Schreiber and Kiefer Sutherland to Om Puri here and Shabana Azmi and so on. And we couldn't get insurance from the you know, companies to ensure the stability and security of the crew in Lahore, which was a real sadness for me.
You know, Meera, racial profiling has been rampant in the West more, and you know, you've lived all over the world and you really know about it.
Mm-hmm.
So, and the recent Boston bombings.
Yeah.
So have you really met with people who actually, you know, suffered that, who've faced it more than, you know, for us it's just a story, right?
I don't have to meet people. I have suffered that, you
really,
know.
Yeah.
I mean, just 10 days ago, I was just in LaGuardia Airport at 6 in the morning and going through the regular security. Mm-hmm. And my mother has given me these lovely bangles which don't come off so easily.
Okay,
and
so
they beeped. and they said, well, they gave me not a strip search, but a spread eagled in front of all the, you know, passengers coming in. Full blue gloves, the whole nine yards, very, very very invasive search.
Yeah, yeah.
And then they put the gloves in the machine and the gloves started beeping. And the woman yelled across the airport, "This woman is alarming," she pointing at me. And of course, the whole world looked at me at that
point. Exactly, yeah.
And, you know, and then the supervisor comes over and says, you know, the gloves are very sensitive and it could be the gloves. And she put it in a machine and it was the gloves, you know.
Wow.
And meanwhile, I'm standing there and I'd been on a conference call with India in the morning just before coming through security. And I said, "Sir, it was 15 minutes already I was standing that way."
Yeah.
And I said, "Can I resume my conference call?
Right.
I'd like to." And he says, "Conference call? 6 a.m.? Who the hell talks on a conference call 6 a.m.? And I said, "Sir, there are other countries in the world and other time zones." I mean, so the duplication of that insularity of not even knowing
exactly
that there are other places in the world, but also this kind of very militaristic sort of surveillance is a deeply, you know, off-putting.
You know, it reminds me of the dialogue from Karan Johar's film. My name is Khan, I'm not a terrorist. Have you seen the film? Have you seen My Name is Khan? Yeah.
Of course I saw it. Yeah,
and
there
is one of a kind for our cinema. What did you think of that?
Well, I thought it was, you know, very effective in some ways. You know, it was, and especially, you know, Shah Rukh's performance is very affecting, the whole thing.
Now, Meera, your films have very strong Indian characters, right?
Yeah.
But they don't always stem from the heartland of India. You know, it's about NRIs and their lives, like the namesake.
Uh-huh.
Right? Have you ever thought of making an all-out Bollywood film, like with all the masala and all the nuances and ingredients that make a Bollywood film?
Well, you know, I make the films I want to make and also how I know how to make them. I mean, Monsoon Wedding is not a, you know, Bollywood per se film, but it's a
Bollywoodish
a film that comes from the heartland of the Punjabi mad family that I come from, you know. And it's, you know, equally commercial as a, you know, people think that, oh, it's art or it's commerce and my movies are what they are, but they also make money around the world, you know. So I don't think in those sort of schematic ways, but I love Nach Gaana Tamasha and I love, you know, the drama of life.
Now here we have this entire Hollywood craze and you, for one, Meera, you're actually refusing to direct Hollywood films. I mean, how do you really do that?
No, I do. I've done many Hollywood films.
No, in recent times?
I made Amelia, I made Vanity Fair.
Vanity Fair,
and Hysterical Blindness, many films, actually. The only one I turned down was Harry Potter, which
I think that is a very, very big one.
That was a big one, but I was 2 months before shooting The Namesake and my 14-year-old son said to me, "Mama, you know, many good directors can make Harry Potter, but only you can make The Namesake."
But Oscar just seems like the ultimate thing, you know, the most aspirational thing. I guess that's why.
Well, you know, I remember when we were nominated for Salaam Bombay, first film 25 years ago.
Right?
Yeah. We didn't even get a telegram from the Indian government. Forget about, you know, there was no craze about the Oscar then, you know.
Wow.
And then India was very far in the Oscar world.
Exactly.
But, you know, finally, of course, it's a public relations, you know, champion of all of that campaigning. But I don't necessarily believe that the Oscar is necessarily about quality all the time.
Absolutely,
or it's really, they call it an Oscar campaign. You have to campaign like you're going to win the presidency of a nation.
In fact, just recently you're having this debate with some filmmakers about some of them thought that, okay, you know, we are really getting there. Our cinema is being recognized. You're going international. Our standards are going higher. And there's a certain segment who thought that, you know what, forget it.
Yeah.
We'll never get there. Our cinema is just not there yet.
Yeah.
So there's always a divided opinion on that.
Well, it's like your cinema is not there according to whom.
Exactly.
You know, it's which point of view are you looking at it from, you know. If you look at a Sholay rocked our minds and hearts here for years.
Yeah.
But if you're looking at it from a Los Angeles point of view, they wouldn't even understand who's Dhanno, who's this, who's that, you know.
Exactly.
And so, you know, why look at it from elsewhere? Look at it from where we are.
Tell me, is the West as star-driven? Like in Bollywood, you often see that, you know, the actor, the star is a hero of the film more than just the script or the story. Does it happen in the West too?
Well, it's not so much more than the story there.
Mm-hmm.
But you certainly, you know, you can't raise money for a film.
Yeah.
That's the dynamics of that.
You
can't
same.
Raise money for a film without known actors in it.
You
know, even The Reluctant Fundamentalist, you know, when we had this extraordinary cast, then it was, even then it was difficult, I must say, because it was such a global film across many continents and it required a certain degree of budget.
Mm-hmm.
But if I didn't have Kate Hudson or Kiefer Sutherland or Om Puri or, you know, or Riz Ahmed, who plays the lead, but he's not as well known. Now he will be. Now they're calling him a star. But then, you know, you have to have a combination of known quantity if you want a budget that will demand.
Right. Now, Bollywood is ruled, like that's what we say, is ruled by these three Khans.
Uh-huh.
Have you ever thought of working with them?
I worked with Irfan Khan.
But the fourth one.
But he's another one.
Yeah, he's another one.
Well, I would love to work, you know, but it depends again on what I'm making, you know.
Yeah.
I'm very, very
calm. Is it tough for, like, chase stars in Bollywood? Considering not, like, you know, you live
I have never chased stars in Bollywood yet.
To get their
dates. Friends.
Yeah.
I have friends. And, I mean, I think the dates would be an issue. But it's all about what, if they would like to respond to, you know, whatever I'm trying to offer.
I guess
them.
They do far more movies in a year, I guess.
Yeah,
so, yeah.
I haven't,
you almost work with Rani and Ranbir for this one, right? Weren't you considering Ranbir at some point for Reluctant?
You know, I audition people, meet people. And it's not quite done here in Bombay. So when you meet someone and you even test them, the news spreads like, oh, he has the part or whatever. It's just assumed.
Are they open to the entire screen?
I mean, now, very much so. I mean, it was, you know, working with, I mean, Ranbir is an incredibly skillful actor.
Yeah.
But it was absolutely a very straightforward situation, and I really love his work.
Meera, tell me, how does it feel when in Hollywood, when there's so many Bollywood films being made and...
Bollywood or what?
No, I mean, there's so many films being made here, and the West also knows of our films to a much smaller extent, but very few can recall names of our stars, our actors, our directors.
Mm-hmm.
But like I just said, you know, while interviewing Jodie Foster, the one name that she remembered was Meera Nair. Mm-hmm. How does that make you feel?
You know,
not like you're a Bollywood filmmaker, but you're still an Indian,
yeah.
I guess.
Oh,
I always,
when they say Indian-born director, I said, I'm not Indian-born, I'm an Indian
you're
director,
Indian,
period. You know. Of course, it makes me feel good, but, you know, really, we must stop looking to the West for approval.
Absolutely.
You know, so I don't get excited at this point of reference. You must be, you know, happy when they remind you.
You spend so much time there, doesn't make a difference to you.
Well,
would any filmmaker here to be like, wow?
But people respect work, you know, and so I don't get excited when, you know, a Westerner recognizes my name. I mean, it's very nice and everything, but it's not, that's not my stamp of talent.
I think
that's real colonial thinking, you know. Happened to go to the Oscars with the same movie, but it was Liberty Cinema that gave me much more excitement. And when those days it was pre-multiplexes, you know, so when we ran for 27 weeks in Eros, when 1,500, 1,000 seats per show you one had to sell, that was my Oscar, you know. know.
Looking forward to seeing more of your movies.
Thank you.
Back here, there, or wherever in the world you are. Great talking to you. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Margarita. Lovely to be here.